Don't you worry about him. There's just one better publicity grabber in town, and that's this Dora Gibson Tucker that runs the Child Welfare and the Americanization League. And the only reason she's got Drew beaten is because she has got some brains.
Well, now, Kenneth, I don't think you ought to talk that way about the doctor. Preacher has to watch his interest, hasn't he? You remember that in the Bible about being diligent in the Lord's business or something.
All right, I'll get something in it for you if you want me to, Mr. Babbitt. But I'll have to wait till the managing editor is out of town and then blackjack the city editor. Thus it came to pass that in the Sunday Advocate Times, under a picture of Dr. Drew at his earnestest, with eyes alert, jaws granite, and rustic lock flamboyant, appeared an inscription, a wood pulp tablet, conferring 24 hours immortality. The Reverend Dr. John Jennison Drew, M.A., pastor of the beautiful Catham Road Presbyterian Church in lovely Floral Heights, is a wizard soul winner. He holds the local record for conversions. During his shepherdhood, an average of almost 100 sin-weary persons per year have declared the resolve to lead a new life and have found a harbor of refuge and peace. Everything zips at the Catham Road Church. The subsidiary organizations are keyed to the top notch of efficiency. Dr. Grew is especially keen on good congregational singing. Bright, cheerful hymns are used at every meeting, and the special sing services attract lovers of music and professionals from all parts of the city. On the popular lecture platform as well as in the pulpit, Dr. Drew is a renowned word painter, and during the course of the year, he receives literally scores of invitations to speak at varied functions, both here and elsewhere. 5. Babbitt let Dr. Drew know that he was responsible for this tribute. Dr. Drew called him brother and shook his hand a great many times.